truck race. You can kind of see the grandstand. It's right like next to that IHOP. It's like right there. Parking the IHOP parking lot is on, I have no idea what the east side of the speedway. Yeah, we're on the east side of the speedway. Yeah, we're going to the truck race. Go check out the gift shop. Spend so much money there. And then, it's on the agenda today. Coke, no calling here on the unfortunately. I do have the backpack. I do have the backpack, but that's it. Try. Looks like they have a collie collar. I said they needed one last year. They have it. I'll see what they got. I'm taking the steps. Why? Because I'm an idiot. That's why. There's an escalator over there, but, you know, Florida sun, you gotta get some kind of a workout in, so, you know, but it is hot. Here we are. Got this sick Haley hat. We're at the top. Start of the concourse. Pretty good right now, man.
Cody stepping back behind the wheel. This family all in the operation.
Point five. That's Timmy Hill. That's I just want a wreck right in front of me. That was it. And they were sliding. Oh, that was sick. I wish I had my phone out, but you obviously can't predict that. But that was so cool. Wow. They were just right there. Sliding back down. Well, the forecast lied. Said it wasn't supposed to rain, and here we are. Going to the grandstand for rain, so. That's sick, dude. Oh, what the frick? I autographed the road last night. I'll show you where it's at. It's right up there. got all of the haulers where they take diecasts that cost 70 bucks and mark them up to 100. So, yeah. Never buy the diecast here, especially if they're 100 bucks. Go to circlebdiecast.com, look for them, use my code BIGGESTFAN, B-I-G-G-E-S-T, F-A-N, biggest fan. You don't need, it's not case sensitive, you can do it all caps, no caps, whatever. Buy them there, so yeah, don't buy them here. They got these tents where you kind of have more Daytona merch and not driver sensitive merch, but they're cool. They're a lot nicer than waiting in the lines at the hauler to just walk around.
You couldn't tell I like diecasts. Alright, I got some stuff for the giveaway I'm doing.
The stuff is like hecka expensive here, so I came in with like a lot of money and it's like all gone like really quickly, but yeah, we'll see. I'm trying to keep the giveaway stuff not super expensive because I also gotta ship it, and if it gets lost or something, you know, that can pose problems. So, but I did get some stuff. I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll also take stuff from my personal calling collection and throw stuff in there, but you know. I got the shirt, I've got to show that, but yeah, having a good time here. It's breezy, so it's actually not that hot. It's cool, but yeah, they got some more stuff around here. Overall, really good day so far.
We have some really cool people. They've got the Hurley shirt on, the NASCAR.
I'll be honest, I think I like the Xfinity cars more than the Cup cars. What do you guys think? I think the racing product has just been better in recent years. So.
I'm very jealous. There's this NASCAR jacket, and it's made by NASCAR.
That's what AJ Allmendinger is coming home with on Monday. I've always wondered what the back looks like. Empty. Yeah, this thing is sweet. One of the best trophies in sports, in my humble opinion. Very cool. Well, I just got done walking the entire midway, and let me tell you, it's not great as far as Friday and Saturday goes. I think Saturday there was a little bit more going on, obviously more people, but we'll see about the 500. I'll walk it again. Yeah, I'm about to enter now, I think. Walking the steps again. Like I said, gotta get some sort of exercise here. And here's the concourse, the 100 level. Tomorrow, I will be the 400 level. Those are the expensive seats, not to brag, but the one thing that sucks is you walk four flights of stairs, and trust me, these ceilings are big, so you're walking a lot, but overall, it's not bad. I'm not sitting that far. I have other people that I'm with, my dad and other family, so I'm on the other side, but I walked the entire midway, so now I get to walk all the way back in the concourse, but I will see you there. Also, quick note, food options. I try my best not to buy food. If you can't tell, I'm winded. I'm like breathing heavy. I had a Coke Zero that they gave me for free that tasted nasty, and it's so bad, but those are the options. Papa John. All right, my family's at 133, so I'm gonna do a time lapse of me walking from 170 to 133. Let's do this. And then we were halfway at the start finish line. I started about the very end. So about halfway. I don't know how long it took in the time lapse. That was definitely a few minutes. So yeah, but real quick, check out this view. That is incredible. I love this place. Also, really quickly, it's not far. I'm gonna show you where I signed the start finish line. Well, I guess the painted start finish line, but I did autograph it and I made my official Daytona 500 prediction right there. Oh, right there, I missed it.
Now, it's going to be finding my family. That's the most difficult part of this. Not walking a mile to get here. There probably wasn't a mile, actually, but... We're doing God Bless America. I missed it, so my bad, but... Sorry, this is gonna be controversial, but there's no view in America that means this to me. There's no place I'd rather be than this, even home, dude. If I could sleep here in a tent, I would. Dead serious. There we go! Caution, come out, number 4 car hit the wall or something. I'm going to get up close right out of turn 4. I think it'd be cool, but I'm shocked. Justin Haley is in like third or fourth right now. He was in the second lane right behind the leaders, behind Allgaier when it happened, so he'll be up front. I'm impressed with how good he is at speedways. Like, truly, he's good at speedways. I'll see you guys in a bit. I was jogging, but I'm not to anymore. I just messaged some people on Instagram about it. No. Alright, I mean, if it wasn't gonna be Haley, it was gonna be him for me. So that sucks, but I think Chandler and Justin were already working pretty well, I saw, so we'll see. And yeah, here's the cars. That's what it sounds like in the grandstands when cars are going by, but... yeah, time to flip sides of the grandstands, and I'll be in the other corner, so. Hey, yo, F Denny Hamlin. All the homies hate Denny Hamlin. Screw that guy, I hate him. Well, Haley in the lead for now. I don't know if you can really see him. Alright, we're almost there. I heard Chandler almost won stage one, but I believe it's second and third for college racing, so he probably won't restart front to back, but hey, that's alright. Alright, the sides of the grandstand have been flipped right over there. You got the Fox camera and all that, pretty cool, but we are literally in the last seat in the corner, so Fox better put me on TV or something. Also, for the record, that's sick.
After having a start at the back, didn't take it very long.
In that bottom lane, Jeb Burton pushing Justin Allgaier up through the middle. Things getting dicey. And there they go, Allgaier around.
Justin Haley got tagged by that, I think.
Fourth caution of the day, third for a problem on track.
Pushing hard through the tri-oval. It's a tough place to be pushing right there. Car's a little light.
Yet again, I don't know if you can hear me, but yet again, a wreck right in front of me. There's our boy, Justin Haley. I want him to win so bad, man. Whatever it takes. Him or Chandler. He's the one, but we're out here with colleagues, so we're going to come from home. There I go. We'll see, but pretty sick. That's the second one that's been right in front of me. Very cool.
Allgaier will be advantaged by a car late. Right behind him.
out at the start finish line. The white flag has been given.
There go the Thunderbirds. Right in front of you. Look at the billboards.
Joey and Harv and Jimmy are going to be a little late to it, but, you know.
Oh, dude, that's sick.
Have a wreck in turn one on the final lap, so. I mean, congrats to Stenhouse. I don't really like him, but, you know, whatever. There we go. He did a little flip around. Grab walk.
Here's Daytona Beach, in case you have never really been here before. The very sand that cars raced on. It is very compact, I'll give it that. It makes sense that they would race cars here, so. Very cool. And that's a Joe's Crab Shack. And then, there's my shadow. So, yeah, this is nice B-roll, peace. And yo, welcome back. Home. We're back in Salt Lake City, Utah, from Daytona Beach. I'm finally back home. It's good to be home. I had a great weekend, man. I'm tired. That plane ride, there's a winter storm going on in Utah right now. So we left 80 degree, like nice, warm sunny weather and came back to a snowstorm blizzard in Utah, and because of it the plane was going a lot slower than normal just to be cautious, so that what's normally like a 4-hour flight, which is still pretty bad, was like over 4.5 hours now. So, you know, but we made it, we're back home. It's good to be back. My feet hurt really bad, so, you know, but yeah, I got an Instagram post about the trip up. Forgive me, I meant to do the giveaway today. Today's the 21st, I think. Tuesday the 21st. I meant to do it today. It's probably going to be tomorrow. I don't have work or anything tomorrow, so it'll just be that. But I need to get together a, number one, the vlog's thumbnail. That's number one that I'm going to try and do tonight, but that won't take very long. I think I can get that done pretty quickly. Number two, giveaway. I need to get that stuff ready, because I don't 100% know what I'm going to do. I know some things for sure, but I need to get, you know, whatever else that I'm putting in there. So, but yeah, overall, really fun trip. I have to say the highlight of the trip would probably be finding out that I missed a DM from somebody from colleague saying that they wanted to meet with me on Sunday and hit me up, like hook me up with a merch pack, like a, you know, swag bag kind of thing. And here's the thing, I got a ton of message requests and my internet was bad, so I'd log in, and the thing with Instagram is, you might know this, I'm sorry about the glare on my glasses by the way, but I don't know why Instagram does this, but on your home screen, if you get a message request, it doesn't pop up with a notification for it, so you can't see it. And then number two, I just had a lot of message requests at the moment, and I said, well, I'm sorry to say, but I was just totally planning on ghosting you guys throughout the weekend. I was focused on trying to go to races and see them, and then I was with family, and my grandparents went with us, so I was trying to spend time with them and my parents and my sister and all of that, and I just didn't get to them. I know it takes 5 minutes, but still, I was pretty much ignoring you guys. I'm sorry, but, and then, what was I going on with this? Internet garbage. It was terrible. We had a really small Airbnb that we were staying at, and when you have 6 people trying to use internet that's meant for probably 3, you run into trouble really, really quickly. So, that was another reason. So, when he messaged me, I didn't get a notification for it. So, it's kind of hard to control. But, you know, we got it figured out. Just by the way, we got it figured out. He is mailing something. I guess they are mailing something. He kind of was phrasing it as he's representing colleague, the actual team and like the company, I guess. So I guess they are putting something together that they're gonna send to me, so really excited. If I get any like duplicates, like I get a shirt or something I already have, I'll give that away too, just for free, but you know, we'll see. But I messaged him and I just said, like, I'm sorry I missed you, like I ghosted you, I did, I'm sorry. But like, it's really nice of you to even just reach out. Like, at the end of the day, that's just cool, you know. I think anybody to even just be hit up by their favorite team saying that they want to meet with you and, you know, get you some t-shirts and, you know, whatever else, it's just, it, like, I don't want to say I'm honored, like, I'm not accepting a Grammy, but it's just cool, like, at the end of the day, to have them even reach out. But he said to hit him up next time I'm going to a race, which will probably be the Charlotte Roval later this year, since I'm moving to North Carolina for school. But it'll probably be Charlotte Roval. I'm gonna bank on that. So yeah, Charlotte Roval. There might be a Biggest Fans Charlotte Roval weekend kind of thing coming up here, but you know, that's not set in stone, of course. I don't even think tickets have gone on sale for that yet, but yeah, we'll see. But it's all under control, it's all good. He told me when he's gonna ship it out, I'll let you guys know. And I'll definitely share all the things I get, but you know, yeah, had to. That merch hauler was sick. I didn't really spend a lot of time vlogging it or anything because I think it's weird. I'm so awkward when I do this in public. I'm so awkward, I can't handle it. But so I try and keep clips short and all of that. But the really cool stuff. Something that I didn't show, they had on the back of the shirts, the design, whatever it had, they had little signs. Okay, I'm sorry, my phone ran out of space, so we're back. There's probably an abrupt cut in there somewhere, but what I was saying is they had those little, like, wall signs, just, like, these plastic, like, wall signs you could put up, I didn't put in, but I thought those were cool, but they were, like, $30, so I probably wouldn't do it. But real quick, oh, hat hair. Oops, jump scare. Let's see. This is really backwards. I'll try and flip it. But Cruisin' Sports, cruisinsports.com. That's who ran the hauler. I haven't checked out their website, but I'm wondering if they have this stuff on their website. But I'll check, and I'll make sure to put a link in the description. I'll also put it up in a little, like, thing right here that says their website and all that. Go check them out. For sure, it's cool. I said last year they needed one so that shopcollegeracing.com wasn't the only way that you could get merch. All right, I really gotta get to the end of this. I ramble on really badly, but thanks to all you guys. Thanks to Colleague Racing. God bless Colleague Racing, man. But seriously, I had a lot of fun this weekend. I can't wait to do it again. And yeah, I hope you have a great season. I think we're gonna win a lot. You know, I genuinely do. I think we're gonna win a lot this year. And I think this is just the start, so. Thank you guys once again. This is Ethan, Colleague Racing's biggest fan. Check it out. I'll see ya very, very soon in the next Instagram post. So, peace.